So E, you want to do E? from my viewpoint, I consider yours.
So how do you know it's yours?
You, if you, yours.
Yeah, it's talking about you specifically. It doesn't say you guys, it doesn't have multiple people. You, yours. You want to do that?
Yours or yours?
Yours?
Yours.
Yours.
No. I want your answer. Yours or your?
It's yours.
Yours.
Yeah. Why would it be yours and not your?
If John and Mary.
Well, I guess the first question is on E. But going back to E, why would it be yours and not your?
Because you think about my point and I think about your point.
Yes, okay. And you just said something
yours.
Important. And that the only way you could use your
we
is,
are
if
agreement.
Is if you had a word after your. Your what? Your viewpoint.
Yeah,
but by saying yours, that's already describing your viewpoint. So then does that make sense why it's yours and not your? Okay. So go ahead with F.
John and Mary could not agree. His views were different from their
context. So what do you think it is?
From hers.
From hers?
Hers. Johnny Mary, John.
Hers.
So, yeah, okay. So John and Mary could not agree. So John and Mary, him and her.
Okay, from her.
Yeah. So his, John's, views are very different from Mary's and hers.
Hers.
Yeah. So hers is the right thing. G, do you want to do G?
We are
entitled to
your opinions.
Your
opinions.
Our.
Okay.
I think your.
What do you think it is? Just you.
We are entitled to our opinions.
Our opinions, yeah. So yeah, we multiple people, and it's using we is what? First person, second person, third person?
First.
So what is the first person pronoun? Would be ours. Yeah, because our includes me. Let's see, H, who hasn't gone yet? H, somebody?
They finally resolve their
differences. Yeah. They finally resolve their differences. So in this case, does they include me?
They are.
What is they? What is they? First person, second person, third person?
They are first person.
Yeah.
They
are there. Oh, third person.
Yeah, so it doesn't include me.
Uh-huh.
So it doesn't, it's not first person. So they, it couldn't be ours, because our includes first person. So they resolve their differences. I, do you want to do I?
She expressed her point of view.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, you want to do?
I have my own ideas.
Okay. And then last but not least, one of you two. Your book has a lot of laughing in it.
It says your view, haven't you?
Okay, you've expressed your view. And remember, in this case, remember, it's not yours view, because it's describing what kind of view. Whose view? Your view. Yeah.
You have S?
No S.
No S.
Because the only way you could use S is if you said, you've already expressed yours. Mm-hmm. Yours basically implying your opinion or view. But in this case, you would just use your. Okay.
Did you have no
You've. So basically, it's just so it's you.
You.
With just the V pronunciation at the end. So you.
I have to add
you.
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 So the V sound for V.
You.
Yeah. You.
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 And what is this short for?
You have.
You have.
You.
So number three, it says complete each of the following sentences with an included clause. So question word plus noun or pronoun plus verb as shown in the example. So be sure to use the correct word order. I'll explain this to you guys. So the example we have is, where is the English book? And basically they say, I'm not sure where the English book is. Letter A, let's see what they have for letter A.
What is John's point of view?
And your John's point. And your John's point of view.
Okay, so I know what?
John's point of view.
Okay, that works.
Right or wrong?
You know, it's right. I think it's right. The book has the answer, I know what John's point of view is. I think your answer would work too. It's shorter. What is John's point of view? What is John's point of view? I know John's point of view. What about B?
I have no. John's point of view is?
John's point is the answer of A.
I know what John's point of view is. So, I know what
John's point of view is.
So the reason this is the correct answer, or I still think your answer would work, but the reason they use this as the answer is the question is, what is John's point of view? So the question is what. So by saying it this way, you're answering what. So I know what John's point of view is. Who wants to volunteer for B?
Why are they arguing? I don't understand. Dash.
What do you think that is?
I don't know. Why are they arguing?
So, basically, you don't understand what.
Yeah. I don't understand. What are they arguing?
Or not what are they arguing, but what's the first word in that sentence?
I don't know what they are.
But you're okay. So the first this will help. So the first part of this is why.
What
are they arguing? So your question, your response here needs to include this. In this case it was what. In this case it is why.
Why.
So I don't understand
why.
Why?
They are arguing.
Arguing.
Yeah.
I don't understand.
You know?
Mm-hmm. basically you want this sentence here, the sentence that you're filling out, to address the question here. So the question here is why? And it starts with, I don't understand why they are arguing. So this here and this here have to be the same. You could not say, I don't understand what they are arguing, because that doesn't have anything to do with why they are arguing. If you said, I don't understand what they are arguing, basically you're saying, I don't understand what they're talking about. In this case, the first question is, why are they arguing? Why are they even arguing in the first place? Not, what are they arguing about? So let's walk through as a group this next one as well. So how many answers are there to this question? What's the key word here?
So, how many?
So,
how many answers?
So I couldn't say
how many answers there are to this question.
Yes, yes. So she said, so again, the key word is how, and it starts off with, I couldn't say
how many answers there are on this question.
Yeah, oh sure.
So you have to.
So I couldn't say how many answers are there or there are.
There are.
Because remember, this is a sentence, this is a statement, not a question. So there are two. Can somebody do D for me? Not all at once, but somebody.
What point are you trying to prove?
Are you reading the answers? That's right. So somebody volunteer for E.
I would like to know what the discussion is all about.
Yes. Yeah, what the discussion is all about. Do you want to do F?
I cannot imagine how long this conflict has been going on.
Conflict.
You want to do G?
Who is the speaker? Please tell me who is the speaker.
Would it be who is the speaker?
Yeah, the speaker. Please tell me who is the speaker.
Well, is this a statement sentence or a question sentence?
Same.
Statement. So you can't say who
is. Who is the speaker?
That's a question now.
Please tell me who is the speaker.
If you said please.
Please tell me.
So watch. Please tell me.
Who is the speaker?
Who is the speaker? You would have to put a question mark at the end of that because that's a question. You can't say like this and have it be a statement because who is a question. So you have it almost right. Who is the speaker? Please tell me who
the speaker is.
So who the speaker is. That way you could not have this comma here and you could say please tell me who the speaker is.
I can use these two sentences.
Oh well.
No, it's not right.
You can use a sentence, but in this example, these are statement sentences that we're supposed to use, not question sentences. So for this example, only this one would be right. Do you mind doing H?
Why?
Oh, I thought you were asking me why.
H.
ให้แต่งหรือว่าอ่าน
อ่านยังไงนะแนวใหม่ให้อ่านแล้วก็ตอบ
แนวใหม่
อ่านข้อ H
Why is he so narrow minded? I found out
why
he so narrow minded.
So why is he so narrow minded? I have found out why he is so narrow-minded. So it's not, I have found out why is he so narrow-minded. That would be a question. Mm-hmm. I have found out why he is so narrow-minded. Do you mind doing I?
What is a radical? I don't know. I don't know. Dash. What a radical is?
Yeah, exactly. So the question is, what is a radical? I don't know what a radical is. And then J, do you ask J as well?
What did the speaker say about the variation?
What did the speaker say about the revolutions? Please repeat.
What did the speaker say about
revolution?
So the question would be, what did the speaker say?
Revolution.
And so the first part of the answer is, or the first part of the statement is, please repeat. So please repeat.
Please repeat. The speaker said about Revolution.
Well, what's the next word here? Please repeat.
What?
What?
So please repeat what?
The speaker.
You got it right.
What the?
Please repeat what the speaker?
The speaker say about.
Say about.
Yeah.
Say about revolution. Revolution.
So, yeah, I think the temptation here is to want to say this or to want to write it in the form of a question. I've heard some people say, please repeat, what did the speaker say about the revolution? It wouldn't be, what did, because what did implies what?
Question.
A question. Please repeat what the speaker said. Would be the sentence or statement that you would use.
Okay, we use second form. Set.
Mm-hmm.
Set. Here is said, but next time we use said.
Okay. So, what did the speaker say? So he already said it. So both of these, the way they're saying it, is in past tense.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you couldn't say here.
If we use did, so we also use say. Please repeat what did speaker says about.
Because if you say what did, that would be a question.
Yes.
So you can't have it as a question in this case. If you wanted to, and this is just for this example, you couldn't have it as a question. But if you wanted to say it like he did, please repeat. If you want to say it as a question, you would say, please repeat, comma, what did the speaker
say?
Say.
Use
question mark.
Yeah. Yeah, so that's one thing I want to point out is that these examples here are specifically dealing with statement sentences. But I know the temptation is to want to ask them in the form of questions, but so if you wanted to ask it in the form of a question, you would say, please repeat, what did the speaker say about the revolution? But if you said, what did, that would have to be a question. So, number four, so it's the last exercise for this unit. Basically, the way they say the directions can be kind of confusing, but it says include the indirect object in brackets, basically the word in parentheses, in each of the statements below, as shown in the examples. With verbs such as give, tell, ask, the indirect object occurs immediately after the verb. With other verbs, to or with precede the indirect object, and the entire phrase is placed at the end of the sentence. So in other words, some of these, so you're going to have a word in parentheses. You're going to have to figure out where in the sentence this word in parentheses should go. Sometimes, the word in parentheses has to be preceded by to or with. Sometimes it's just going to be the word by itself. So, for example, using the example, the teacher asked a question, and the student is the word in parentheses. So, the way you put the student in the sentence would be the teacher asked the student a question. So let's move on to the second example. The teacher discussed the question. Him is the word in the parentheses. So in this case, the way you put him in the sentence would be, the teacher discussed the question with him. So, and in this case, remember, as I said in the example or the directions, was some words will require you to put to or with before the noun. So in this case, you have to say not only him, but with him. The third example is the teacher repeated the sentence. Them is the word. The teacher repeated the sentence to them. Yes. So go through just for a few.